is brought down by sea in the company's colliers to the gasworks, and it is lifted out of the ship's holds 3.5 tons at a time. It starts on its journey through the gasworks on overhead conveyor belts, going first to the storage bunkers, where it remains until it is wanted for use. There are really four methods of making gas, one of the most common being in the horizontal retort. Coal is fed into the retorts and cooked in intense heat for 10 to 12 hours, during which time it gives off a rich brown coal gas. After this baking, the coal has changed into coke, which is pushed out by a powerful ram. This falls out of the other side of the retort into a trough where it is cooled or quenched. And after the retorts are emptied, a charging machine moves into position and fills them again with coal ready for the next baking. Meanwhile, the coke will be sorted and sold to outside industrial or domestic consumers, while some of it will be used to provide further heat for the coal in the retort. The rich crude gas that came from the coal has a much more complicated route to travel. But first, let us see the other methods of gas manufacture. These are coke ovens, and are another method of producing gas and coke. Coal is heated in these ovens 16 tons at a time, and in 19 hours is fully carbonized. A powerful ram pushes out the coke, which falls into a waiting car on the other side. Quenched under a water tower. After cooling, it is taken off to be graded and prepared for industrial or domestic users, or to make more gas. Gas produced in the coke ovens has been flowing along the gas main. Now for another method. These are known as intermittent vertical retorts and operate in a similar way to the coke ovens. Roughly speaking, they are small coke ovens with the coke coming out of the bottom instead of the sides. After emptying, the retorts are left open at the top so that a draft of air may blow through them, and they are inspected to see that all the coke has dropped into the skip below. Underneath, the skip, full of red-hot coke, moves away to be quenched under the water tower, and after cooling, the coke is taken away to be graded. A charger moves into position on the top of the retort and fills them up again with coal for the next baking. The fourth method of producing gas from coal is in continuous vertical retorts. The principle of carbonizing is the same, but this method differs slightly from the others because the coal is continuously moving downward through the retort, which is not being recharged as in the other method. The coke produced in a coke oven is more suitable for large furnaces, but for domestic use, coke produced in this manner is preferable. although gas is made from coal, it can also be made from coke. Here in the Fulham water gas plant, air, then steam, is blown over red-hot coke, which produces a gas called blue water gas. In its normal state, it has not the same heating value as coal gas, so oil is added to increase its heating value. Later, in the gas manufacturing station, this oil gas, or carbureted water gas as it is called, is added to the purified coal gas to balance the heating value. And this mixture is the gas that flows to your homes. And what of the coal gas produced in the retorts and coke ovens? It now starts on various stages of purification and, after cooling in a series of condensers, produces the first of the crude byproducts, tar. This first byproduct, which also contains a percentage of ammonia, is treated in the products works nearby. Scientifically and with careful precision, so that nothing is wasted, it is broken down into all its various compounds. This is called fractionating. Pitch, for instance, which is poured into enormous beds, will be taken away later on, mostly to be used overseas in the making of briquettes for heating. Nothing is thrown away, for tar contains valuable commodities. From it are derived all the valuable coal tar dyestuffs, toluene, creosote, synthetic perfumes, and many others. Large quantities of refined naphthalene are made into mothballs on the spot. Tar itself is refined and used on the road in tar spraying, for it gives a dustless, non-skid surface. Large quantities are sold not only to the home market, but to extensive markets overseas. From these works, over 400,000 barrels of tar are sent out every year, and a further 2 million gallons are used by tar spraying fleets which operate from Southall or Beckton. Continuing its long journey through the gasworks, the gas next passes through a series of washers. This not only cleans the gas, but removes ammonia and some light oils. In the products works, the ammonia is treated with sulphuric acid, which makes sulphate of ammonia. This, of course, is a very valuable fertilizer for the land. After the washers, the gas passes through these beds of iron oxide known as purifiers to remove the sulphuretted hydrogen. By chemical action, the oxide is decomposed, leaving pure sulfur mixed with it. The spent iron oxide is burned to drive off the sulfur fumes, and from it, sulphuric acid